Hello guys, Rafiq is here from USOF. In the previous video, we already talked about how to manage databases and query form. But maybe you want to integrate the data with another application, right? Now, I want to explain how to use API documentation so we can integrate our application with other application later. Let's head to API documentation menu. As we can see here, Badaso use Swagger technology to serve API documentation. If you already know about Swagger, that's good, but if you didn't, let's try it. In this page, there's already some default API endpoints. Those are out right here, and then User API and Upload File API. In this video, we are gonna talk about Auth API. So, another application like Android or iOS can also use Badaso authentication system. As you can see here, this endpoint called /v1/auth/verify in real case, you need to verify email for new register account. But for the sake of simplicity, we will turn off the should verify email register in configuration menu. Then scroll it down and should verify email after register, turn it off. And then click update configuration button. So we can go to the API documentation menu. First, we can try the register API. Select user registration and then click try it out. As you can see, there's a default JSON body template and we can modify it. We can keep the default value for name and the email key. Then we must add one more key. There is username, and for the value, just make sure it must be unique, because when this video was taken, Badaso API documentation didn't update yet. So when this video is released, you don't need to add that key manually. For the password key, type 1234 and we can copy it and paste it on password confirmation. After finish, we can click the execute button. And our request success. And we get 200 code. As we can see, our request is success and get 200 code. Also, you can see the API response here. After the user has registered, we must give the access to that user. Okay. Just go to user management menu. And then click the three dots for registered user and then select roles. For example, we will choose administrator. After finish, click set selected roles for user button. And then we will back to API documentation menu. Next, we can log in with the account that we currently created. Just select Login Authentication API and then click try it out. And this is the default email before. For the password, 123456. And then for the remember key, just let it false. Okay. After finish, click execute button. As we can see, our request is success and we get 200 code with the response body. You can use the access token value for authorization later for each feature in Badaso. Next, for explain how to use token in this API documentation, we can try access an API from a feature that needs authorization to access it. In the previous video, we already created a menu called food categories, like here, so we can test the API of it. For this tutorial, we will try the list API. This API will return the list of food categories. Before accessing the API, we need to input the token that we got before. Okay, so just scroll up here and click the padlock icon. Okay, this pop-up need to be read out. We can copy it from access token. Okay, just copy this value and then paste it on here. Click authorize and we are authorized. Okay, and then close the pop-up. We'll back to food categories API list and we will try to see our data in food categories. Okay, just select this API, click try it out. Because this API doesn't need a parameter, just click execute. As you can see, the API will return the response that contain list of food categories. And the other software developer can use this data to another application. Okay, that's it. In the next video, we will explain about how to use File Manager on Badaso. If you have any question, please comment below. Thank you. See you in the next video.